Hello wonderful person, this is Anton, and in this video we're going to be once again talking about the second interstellar comet known as Borisov, and also a few other details about the new comet that's going to be possibly visible in about a month or so. This comet is known as Atlas. But today I wanted to talk about some of the updates, and also a little bit of history in regards to comets in general. So let's talk a little bit more about this, and welcome to What the Math. Now first of all, this simulation right here shows you the difference between two interstellar comets we've discovered in the last few years. This is the Oumuamua and the Borisov comets, and as you can see, the second comet was actually moving a lot faster than Oumuamua, which is why we were so interested in it, because essentially this was a telltale sign that it came from the outside of the solar system and was probably one of the more unique objects that we actually got to investigate in a lot of detail in the last few months. Now, in December of 2019, roughly around Christmas time, this is when the comet was at its closest to our planet, and this is why a lot of astronomers were actually referring to Borisov as the so-called Christmas comet. It provided quite a lot of various opportunities for scientists to study it in a lot of detail, and we actually had some of the most detailed studies about comets coming from this visitor right here. Now, this is the Borisov comet as it was imaged by Hubble telescope, and right next to it you can see a tiny galaxy, just for comparison. And most of the studies focused on the composition and also on the amount of material that was being released by the comet. And so one of the more recent studies kind of summarizes everything we know about this so far, and it really is not as exciting as a lot of us were hoping this would be. In other words, this comet seems to be similar to a lot of other comets we've observed, both in terms of composition, structure, and even in some sense, size. The recent studies determined that it's actually a relatively small object. It's approximately 400 or so meters in radius, or basically about 800 meters across, which is, I guess, somewhere around 2500 feet. But that's the maximum size possible. The telltale sign that this was not a big object was actually from one of the recent observations. The scientists made an assumption that there was about 10% chance that this comet is going to fall apart and basically get shred apart by the relatively close approach to the sun. In other words, it was probably going to separate into tiny pieces and possibly become more than one chunk. And it just so happens that from the previous observations of other comets, we know that smaller comets have a lot less likely chance to fall apart because they just don't have enough gravitational force to keep them together. And here is what the most recent images of the comets look like. Here, in this observation, it's quite obvious that it slowly starts falling apart and forms separate pieces that start flying away at a speed of about 1 foot per second, or about 30 centimeters per second. As a matter of fact, the distance between these two pieces is about 180 kilometers. So this tells us that this comet is no longer a single piece, it's basically at least two pieces, but possibly even more than that. And the most recent observation discovered that it's kind of now even much smaller, and all of the other pieces seem to have disappeared completely. So this is actually the observation from just yesterday, from when I'm making this video, and here it's quite obvious that there's really just one piece again, even though there were several pieces in here previously. All of which allowed the scientists to very thoroughly analyze the composition of the comet, the amount of the actual material that's being ejected, and also even calculate the speed of the ejection, all of which we now know with a lot of detail. So for example, we now know that approximately 0.5% of the material was released really early on, and the comet was about 14 times the size of planet Earth if you were to measure just the size of the tail. The comet was losing approximately 62 kilograms per second, which is actually quite a lot of material lost, and the material itself was being released at speeds of approximately 4 to 7 meters per second, or approximately 20 feet per second. So this is essentially what gives a lot of comets a bit of a propulsion and changes their trajectory as they move across the solar system, which also allows us to then estimate how much of the mass was lost in total. We've also been able to analyze the composition of this tail, and for the most part it's either carbon-based or amine-based. Basically it has a lot of the same components that normally form things like amino acids, and also a lot of other components that normally form organic molecules. And of course a lot of water as well. In other words, it sort of contains a lot of similar materials to what other comets in the solar system contain. The material, for the most part, that's responsible for bringing all of this organic stuff and all of the water to planet Earth and then helping the life start as well. which of course implies even more evidence for other star systems having really similar conditions to our own solar system and possibly even having planets similar to Earth. But since we have no idea where this comet came from, we're not going to be able to answer the question of what kind of a solar system or a star system was able to create something like Comet Borisov. And so far, all of the recent images did show us that essentially this comet is being disintegrated really, really fast. It's probably already lost a huge chunk of its original mass and most likely became just the dust that you see right here that's going to be circulating across our solar system for the years to come. But it's also going to at some point leave the solar system because most of it is moving really, really fast. And even though we originally thought that maybe we could plan a mission to go here and to try to investigate this in a little bit more detail, because it's moving so fast, the earliest we could ever reach this comet would be 2045. And by then, it's probable that this comet is going to be really tiny, super small compared to what it was originally. So unfortunately, these are probably some of the last studies we're going to be hearing about this beautiful comet. Because now we have a new contender for the comet of the year, the comet known as Atlas. Discovered right after Christmas of 2019, this is now going to be the most studied object for the next few months or so, mostly because we expect it to be very bright and possibly even bright enough to be seen with a naked eye by the time of its closest approach to the sun around late April or May. So if we're lucky enough, this could be that one comet we've all been waiting for, because it's been quite a long time before a comet was actually visible to us. The first time I've ever seen a comet was actually back in 1997. This was the comet known as Halley-Bopp, and it's not going to be back for quite a while. But the newly discovered comet known as Atlas is not an interstellar object, and is more of a long-term comet that actually approaches Earth every 6,000 years or so. So the last time we've actually seen this comet was around 4000 BC. Which actually kind of brings me to the other topic I wanted to briefly discuss, the word disaster, which is probably kind of related to what's happening around the world right now. The original idea for comets has actually always been the messengers of the god. This was true of pretty much most of the cultures around the world, including various Chinese cultures that have documented comets for generations, which actually is one of the reasons why today we know what comets are. Because the astronomers of 18th and 19th century using the ancient Chinese documents were actually able to then start understanding them a little bit more. They realized that these objects do seem to appear periodically, and it was something that was natural and not something that was related to any kind of religion. But what's really interesting though is that both in the Chinese cultures and in ancient European cultures, the comets, depending on their shape and color, represented different things. Like for example, from what I remember reading, if it was a sword-shaped comet, or basically a tail that was a little bit curved, it would indicate some sort of a major warlike event. And one of the most famous comets, simulated right here in Space Engine, is the famous Halley's Comet. It comes around every 75 years or so, and has unfortunately been blamed for many different disasters around the planet. Now here's the thing though, the word disaster itself means bad star. And so until recent times, comets were actually disasters. They were bad stars, they were representations of something bad happening. Which is probably why in May, you're going to be hearing a lot of astrology reports on how this is basically the omen of the current pandemic that's going on around the world. But going back to the original images I showed you from China and from ancient Europe, these ancient images allowed us to understand that this is just something that happens regularly and can happen at any time. Pandemics are totally not related to any of this. And even though the earthquake in Switzerland in 1300s and also the outbreak of plague in London in 1600s, and even the assassination of Julius Caesar were all blamed on the famous Halley's Comet, this was of course before we understood what's really happening here. Thanks to the meticulous record keeping of the Chinese astronomers and various observations from early European astronomers, today we know that this is not what's happening, and we can easily predict comets even before they become visible and then track them for a very long time afterwards. And so, even though naturally people are kind of predisposed to blame various negative events on something unpredictable, something that we have no control over, something even astronomical, that's not really what's happening. And hopefully one day we'll stop relying on the ideas from astrology and from misunderstanding these space events and slowly move on to the next chapter of human understanding of being able to identify and also understand, predict and prevent various actual disasters from happening around our planet. But going back to the original topic of Comet Borisov, looks like its saga is finally over and we can now say goodbye to this beautiful object. We're probably never really going to visit this object, but it's very likely we're going to discover another interstellar object sometime in the next few years. Since we were able to discover these two so quickly, I'm sure another one will come our way pretty soon as well. But while we're waiting for those objects to show up, hopefully in May, we're going to be able to see this beautiful Atlas comet and admire its beauty as well. This is something that doesn't happen very often and something that a lot of people will be seeing for the first time ever. So I'm actually pretty excited because I'm going to try to find the darkest spot I can actually find somewhere in the country, go there and take a lot of pictures of this beautiful object. Although hopefully by then the quarantine thing will be over, and if not, well, I guess I'm gonna have to wait until another comet shows up. And anyway, on that note, that's all I wanted to mention in this video. Check out the paper about Comet Borisov in the description below, and come back tomorrow to learn something you may have not known before. Also, consider supporting this channel on Patreon, it does help me quite a lot. Alternatively, you can also support this channel by buying the beautiful, wonderful person t-shirt that you can find in the description below. I'll see you tomorrow, space out, and as always, bye-bye.